I'm JD McPherson, and I sing and play guitar.
I'm Jimmy Sutton, and I play the bass.
Jason Smith, I play the drums.
My name is Ray Vasildo, and I play keys.
My name is Doug Corcoran, I play sax, guitar, and stuff.
So here's how this all went down. I met him on MySpace, and we recorded an album together, and then we put in a band together. We got Jason on the drums because he was in a band that we really liked. And then I met Ray at a party. Just so happened that he played keys really well, so he joined the band. And then Doug came through Jimmy's contacts in the Chicago music scene, blues scene, because he's a guy that does a lot of blues. And so that's that Home of the Blues. So that rounded out the whole thing. And that's how we all did it. That's how we all met. That's how we got started. 100%. I dig rock and roll 100%. So that's what we do. You know, try to play it with as much physical commitment as possible. Primary influences for me would be like Little Richard, the Delphi records, especially Richie Valens and Chan Romero. I really, really dig Irma Thomas a whole lot, a lot of the New Orleans R&B, and then I just all kinds of anything else from Madonna to Stiff Little Fingers and everything in between.
Well, he does. He listens to a lot of Madonna.
I do. I bummed everybody out hard with ABBA the other day.
Oh, man.
There's a little, maybe a little pinch of David Lynch thrown in there. I just remember being in high school and watching Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me, and I didn't know anything about that. And then I met this guy named Sean, who said, "Hey, man, you need to watch David Lynch movies." And so I watched that movie, and it like flipped me out. And it's like that was sort of like when I started having my first like original thoughts. When my, you know, when my brain turned on, I guess, was when I started watching those movies. They have an atmosphere to them that I enjoy, and so I don't know. Some of that stuff sneaks in pretty frequently, I guess.
A lot of the oddball kind of rockabilly and rock and roll tunes kind of probably even influenced David Lynch.
That's true.
And kind of also, if you look at rock and roll, there's the countryside and there's the uptown side, and you kind of put those two together, and that makes a real interesting sound too.
Rounder Records, our record label, whose parent company is Concord Music, they're sort of an archival label. They take care of a lot of important old labels, and they had just acquired all the publishing for vee-jay. And vee-jay, if you don't know, is really, really important label out of Chicago. That was like the home of Jimmy Reed, John Lee Hooker, Staple Singers, anything you can think of.
The Duke of Earl.
Come on, Gene Chandler. That's on vee-jay.
The Shy Lights.
Holy smokes, the Shy Lights. The Beatles.
The Beatles, that's right.
The Beatles, that was the label that first put the Beatles out in the United States. So it was this really cool label, and they asked if we wanted to, said, "You can record anything you want because we have the publishing for this now." And said, "Let's do one better and let's make a vee-jay 45 and release it first." So we recorded a 45 and released the first vee-jay release since 1965, I believe.
One song is a Billy Boy Arnold blues song, and the flip side is a song called Steal Away by
Jimmy Hughes. And then those became a digital EP also. We put those four things together and made a digital EP called the Warm Covers EP.
Can you talk about what's the weirdest thing that you've discovered about one of your bandmates?
Man, don't even open that can of worms, Sean.
That's probably not a good idea.
Best leave that one alone, man. You shouldn't ask that question. Really?
Most of the dirt is on you.
Come back, baby, I wish you would. Come back. Come back, baby, I wish you would.
is JD McPherson, and you're watching Channel Sound.